So what are the benefits of such a movement? First of all, it helps stretch unclog our meridians. It also helps regulate our breathing and collect our thought.
我现在在 Zoom 里面直播。
那为什么呢？因为全院讲叫行不正则气不顺，气不顺则意不宁，意不宁则神散乱。所以我们中正安舒的特点呢，可以帮助气顺、意宁、敛神。
And why do we need to have those benefits? Because as was described by the ancients, improper movement leads to impeded qi. Impeded qi leads to a restless mind, and a restless mind leads to diffused spirits. And so in this case, we need to get our movement right, get our qi in a still state, and also with that, concentrate on our mind.
那柔缓连绵的特点，它契合有氧运动啊。如果我们啊有研究表明，如果我们锻炼时间超过三十分钟以上，啊，它就可以使我们的血粘度减小，但是呢，血小板的数量不会改变。
So, when combined with the suitable aerobic exercise, the prescriptions actually.For example, quite often when we practice for over 30 minutes, it will help reduce our viscosity of our blood. So when the aerobic movement or exercise is further intensified, that means to increase its intensity to medium intensity or even above, it will help with improving the heart and lungs functions.
同样呢，它对防控基础病，就是高血压、糖尿病啊，还有这个，还有这个，亚健康啊，都有很好的作用。
And it will also be very effective in the treating with such symptoms as diabetes, and hypertension, as well as what we describe as subhealth. Conditions.
但是这里要值得注意的是，如果我们要结合运动处方练习呢，我们可以把它时间延长，但是我们不一定要在追求运动强度上面呢，追求的很到位，或者说中等啊，或者中等强度以上，我们没有必要做到这样。
So in this case, all we need to do is to focus on increasing the intensity of our exercise, but we don't really have to be that particular as to what's the medium and what is the above medium.
因为我们的这个身体动作的练习，主要还是要为这个调节呼吸，这个意手。
So don't be that particular about the too exacting really about our particular moves or poses, because after all, the form is to serve the other two purposes, namely regulation of our breathing and concentration of our mind.
现在我们的研究发现，我们同样这个在用这种方式，在低强度、小运动量的情况下，也可以达到同样的这个有氧运动的效果，比如说心肺功能的增加和这个基础病的控制。
Actually, studies have found that even exercises with some moderation, with lower intensity, still help us as a kind of aerobic exercise with improving the lungs and heart functions and also addressing the problems faced with the underlying pre-medical or pre-health conditions.
那就为这个健身气功啊，就这就是健身气功成为一个
你说是对的，你让他早止，
有效而且是
终身锻炼的手段提供依据。
And this provides the foundation for Health Qigong as an economical and effective means for us to be practiced for life.
这里举的是一些例子啊。
So I'm citing some examples here.
然后放松肢体呢，我们可以增强我们的气血在体内的流动，也就是可以增强我们的气感。
So we need to relax because by relaxing, we can actually increase the flow of qi in our body and also the facilitate the movement of qi and blood within our body.
当然呢，我们这种放松肢体、增强气感呢，是通过我们在锻炼当中把这个肢体放长放远，用意念引导，把肢体放长放远，这样呢可以实现这个人在气中，也可以实现气在人中的这种效果。
So we achieve this relaxation and also the increase of the field of qi by actually using our mind to guide it and also to have the moves extended so that we get the field of qi within, not only the man in the qi, but also qi within the man or the human being.
那这种动如流水风的特点也就是柔和圆匀的柔和匀圆缓的特点呢，
它是伤我们的 soon 吧，它不是说伤钉钉吧，你看他说是 soon
这个
他没走出钉钉去放这个就不行了，他有可能是你们是
降这个运动损伤
和运动中的意外的发生。
So this particular feature of the moves being gentle and smooth also have another effect, namely it will help us with preventing some hazards, for example, certain injuries in our practice.
大家就看到这个河边的垂柳，在这个初春的寒风中，风摆摇曳，它是很难被折断的，因为它以柔克刚。
We can see the willow trees along the banks of the river. The leaves, the twigs, actually, they are not easily broken in the cold spring winds, all because they are so soft, so pliable. So they use this pliableness, this gentleness to overcome the hardness.
这就是我这个意思，就是我们在练习当中采用这样的方式，就不会引起就是可以把肢体损伤的这个危险性降低，就关节肌肉韧带。
In other words, by using such a means of gentleness in our practice, we can reduce the probability of suffering from injuries. For example, that applies to our muscles, our joints, our tendons.
同样的这种低强度柔缓的练习呢，可以使我们的植物神经得到调节，使我们内脏的功能呢逐渐的改善，这样可以预防心脑血管意外的发生。
And also similarly, with such exercises of lower intensity and moderation, it will also help with regulating or improving our nervous system, and also the preventing heart and brain symptoms.
这也就是我们健身气功和健身气功导养生功十二法。
And that's also one of the reasons why Health Qigong in general and Shafa, this Daoyin Yangsheng Gong in particular, is so popular among people who are middle aged or elderly and among also patients as well.
中正安舒的这个技术要点有很多，我这里呢，时间关系呢，就给提醒大家一个，比如说我们要讲到提顶，或者叫做晨间拔顶。And
now let's talk about the practice key points, or the key points for practice. For us to attain the goal of being upright and relaxed, one thing we need to do is to lift the top, that means the head, and also to lower the shoulders.
这里讲呢，就是你要想沉肩，要想拔顶，首先要把肩沉下去。
So in this regard, in order to lift your top, you need to lower your shoulders first.
就是说肩一沉，下颌一收，下颌一收，百会就灵起来了。你不用去使劲去顶百会，这样你的颈椎就会僵硬。In
other words, if you want to lift your 百会, actually you don't do it literally. You just lower your shoulders and tuck in your chin, and the 百会 will go up naturally. So don't focus on lifting the 百会.
对，大家不要理解错了，说是拔顶垂肩，这个是做反了，一个是沉肩提顶。
So
那么我们这里给一个口诀。
So don't get the order wrong. You don't lift the top and then lower the shoulders. Rather, you lower the shoulders so that you lift the top. So here we have a rhyme to help you with it.
我们这里给一个口诀，叫做玉体顶来，肩下沉，下颌微收，天津神。为什么天津神呢？因为你这个督脉被牵引了，然后使它畅通，督脉畅通呢，阳气上升。And
here, actually, may I add that Professor Hu is very good with a lot of poems. Here he actually has a verse for us to remember this by, especially in Chinese, in rhymes. So it says, to lift the top, you lower the shoulders. Tucking in the chin slightly, you lift your spirit. And in this case, why do you lift your spirit? Simply because when you are able to unclog your Du meridian, it will help with the rise of your yang qi, and that in return will lift up your spirit.
陈先生很客气，说我会有很多好的诗，其实不是，是就是便于大家记忆的顺口溜。
Professor Hu is being very modest, says that he just invented all these, came up with all these verses in order for you to make it easier. To commit to memory the moves.
另外还有一个大家耳熟能详的叫含胸拔背。
Another term that's very familiar to you is called han xiong ba bei in English. That means taking in the chest and also actually pulling out the back.
但是呢，这个呢，大家喊口号喊了很多年啊，每个人练功呢，一上来了都能听到这个。但是我一问呢，你怎么样含胸拔背呢？怎么样体会啊？什么体验？怎么样去检验？怎么做？啊，基本上没有人答出来。
Even though many of you have been practicing, many of you have been practicing with this term for a long time, have been saying 含胸拔背 for years.But when the professor who asked his students or people, other practitioners, how do you go about that? And somehow, how do you verify that you have got the move right? It seemed that no one was able to answer his question correctly.
其实含胸拔背呢，要求呢，就是胸部微含，这个很简单，但是呢，胸部微寒呢，你的感觉是什么呢？应该是在第五胸椎，就是肩胛骨啊，这个肩胛骨中间啊之间呢有，好像贴了块膏药，有点膨胀。这个呢，我就用脊背加宽又加长来形容。
Even though it's described here as han xiong, is taking in your chest a little bit. Actually, you can actually imagine your chest actually up to the fifth disc. It's as if there were a patch of some ointment, on your body. You somehow spread this part.Surrounding the fifth disc.
那大家体验和检验怎么做呢？就是把两手相叠在丹田。把两手相叠在丹田，然后你两个手臂呢，注意两肘呢要稍稍抬起，形成一个两臂形成一个立圆。这样的话呢，你的背部的感觉啊，胸部的感觉，就是含胸拔背的感觉。
Actually, the way to do this correctly is to overlap your hands, above or rather over your 丹田, and then with your elbows out, so as actually your arms are actually forming what's called a vertical circle, and that way you already have the chest in a little bit and also your back out stretched.
大家如果体会不到的就经常这样做这个时候的腋下呢是虚空的，我们说好像可以放一个鸡蛋进去。
So if you don't get the feel yet, you try to practice with this move as described by a professor who having the vertical circle formed by the two arms with your hands overlap over your 丹田. And also meanwhile, actually, you need to have both armpits hollow as if you were able to put an egg under each armpit.
还有一种中正安舒呢是要求斜中正的，这个我们应该注意。
Actually, the requirements, one of the requirements for getting this upright and relaxed position is what we call being upright but still slightly tilted.
做盘根，比如说做盘根步的时候，我们就应该承宽脸臀承宽收腰，然后呢把百会拧起来，但是这个时候呢不是直上直下，一直上直下肯定是挺胸塌腰的气势沉不到丹田的。
So we can take one example, what we call the 盘根步。盘根步 is like the roots that are twining and then squatting down. It's translated as entangled step. or entangles tends. And in this case, actually, you are not sitting down straight down vertically, and you need to lower your hip and also tighten your hip while relaxing the lower back and lifting your top. And you don't just sit down vertically, because that way, actually, it will be counterproductive. It will actually not help you getting the right move. And we also have the, it's called the 侧弓步, that's the bow stance, but not straight. It's slightly slanted in direction. And that's the move you can find in Jichang, shooting at the Lies, at the Laos rather. And that also requires the body to lean forward a little bit, not remaining up straight.
我把这种姿态呢，中正安舒的姿态呢，比作像这个王羲之写的这个词叫虚怀落足，清品游兰。
So, Professor Hu likens such a move for being upright and relaxed to a poem by a very famous poet by the name of Wang Xizhi in China. Actually, he is regarded by most Chinese as the most famous Chinese calligrapher. And he has on display here. 那个胡老师，您能不能放回去那个书法？ 让大家看见，清品幽兰那儿。
现在是放着的。哦，再放好。现在是放着的。啊，对对对，我现在看到了，那个。
So on the lower left corner, actually, you can see the calligraphy. It reads vertically from right to left. It says, 虚怀若竹, that means you have your self, just liken yourself to a bamboo, for example. That means you have need to have magnanimity. Hollow inside, that means you are being modest inside, but also up straight. Upright like a bamboo. On the left, 清品幽兰, simply likens your personality to an orchid. Orchid to the Chinese means something that that's not only fragrant but not exaggerated. Actually, also referring to someone who is very honest and modest.
柔缓疏匀呢，我们就要注意在练习的时候呢，要注意以腰为轴，节节贯穿。Now
talking about the moves that need to be gentle and smooth, we need to have our waist as the axis, and then we move sectionally. That means one part of the body first, sequentially all the way down or all the way up.
因为这个这种练习可以把这个你的劲力或者说气血传递到这个最远的末梢。This
way of exercise
爆发出来的能量呢是无穷的。It
will enable you to have your force, your qi, and your blood go as far as possible, and the force that comes out more or less like an explosion, actually, and that's unlimited.
大家看到这个左边这个图吗？我们的水车，拉水是从底下一节一节的往上的，就是。
Can you see the diagram on the the picture on the bottom left. Actually, that was, still is, a Chinese tool for the farmers. They use this as a means to lift the water from a lower altitude to a higher one. And actually, this machine actually made of wood contains of sections, more like the drawers we have. But one section moves up and the other like a chain. And so you can see it's also doing the lifting the water section by section in a continuous manner.
这个呢，大家可以想象啊，这个有名的蝴蝶效应，多米勒普台效应啊，最开始就一点小小的一个啊，就可能是一根稻草就可以给它启动啊，蝴蝶稍稍扇动一下翅膀，但是它带来的。
So you can also liken this to the domino effect or the butterfly effect. That is, even though you start as light as a straw, for example, and then eventually with the increase of the effect, so the actual result is unlimited.
全言也讲，当我们下沉的时候，要起于根，顺于中，达于梢。当我们起的时候呢，要烧结起，终结髓，根结椎。So
in the Wushu practice, we have a lot of sayings. Among them, there are two here that I would like to quote. That is, in doing your moves, you start from the roots, follow through to the middle, and then reach the extremities. Or in other words, you can also start from the what's called the end section and then follow it in the middle section and then chase, that means you end up in the root section.
可是很可惜的是，我看到很多练习者呢，当他手要往上摆的时候，要提手的时候呢。 都是先把肩扛起来，然后再把肘提起来，然后再把手提起来，这个呢是达不到这个效果的。But
most regrettably, quite often I see practitioners when they want to lift the hands, they actually lift their shoulders or their elbows first, and that actually won't help you with achieving the desired effect.
要想达到这个特点，要想实现这个特点，我们首先要明白道理，加强基本功练习。最重要的要有观察思考，就观察河边春风拂柳的那种意境。So
to achieve the desired effect in our practice, for this particular movement, we need first of all to observe. And to think, we need to build up our basic skills, and we can also observe the spring breezes caressing the willows by the river banks.
那么第二个呢，就是要根据需要来制定运动处方，包括我们的运动处方的这个强度。 时间频度.
And secondly, we need to formulate an exercise prescription, as we call it, according to the needs. So that applies to the intensity, the time, the frequency of our practice.
好，那第二个特点呢，就是适应原道，对称协调。Now
the second feature rather of our this particular regime is it has circular movement and symmetrical coordination.
这个呢，大家都非常容易理解。 就是这个动作呢要有弧度。
So this should be easy to understand. That is, all the moves need to be curved in the trajectory.
对称协调呢就更好理解了。就是上下相随啊，左右对称啊，前后相容，等等等等。
And by symmetrical coordination is even easier to understand. That is, upper and lower parts of the body should follow each other, and the left and right should be symmetrical, and also front and back should be cohesive.
大家看看这些动作，像双鱼悬阁。我们搭完以后，手不是直接往前摆，先往后，再向前平移的，像这个地方，然后转身先不是回来，靠腰的转动带动它回来，然后看这个手臂的收，它收的时候先往上，然后再收回，然后再往下，再往上推出，这个是就是四运圆道。全院讲太极拳的全院讲叫做四要圆，五死有凹凸，同时呢，他一些要求，含胸拔背啊，松腰敛臀呐，这些要求都契合这个。
So as you can see in the video， 继续放吧，放那个对，as you can see in the video。Actually, for example, this is a move in the double fish hanging in the house. And you can see that in order for you to move out, you need to take in the hands first before you move out. And also you lead with your waist rather than leading with your hands. And you move, for example, if you want to go up, you also go down first. And your moves also have to be curve or circular. So that's actually essentially described in wushu practice. You need to have this circle. And also you also need to throw in the other requirements. For example, as we mentioned earlier, you need to take in your chest and pull out your back, and also relax your lower back and take in your butt.
刚才讲的斜中正啊，大家看到像这个下蹲的时候。
Now, this is leaning. You are squatting, but you are leaning forward. This is what we call the tilted uprightness, not vertically, 100%.
大家好，现在这个钉钉网上他们那个停了，所以暂时看不见啊，可能等一下要再回来啊，稍他稍稍等一下啊，不知道为什么他们那边停了。还是不行，大家看得见吗？刚才，但是现在看不见的吧，应该是啊。现在要稍等一下了啊，我再找找能不能有没有其他的。我估计是因为他们那边那个钉钉的网的那个传送有问题，所以咱们也没办法直播了啊。对。不过没问题，很快我相信他们很快就回来了，啊，等一下大家以后有兴趣的可以练一练导引养生功十二法，是由我们的啊最敬爱的老师张广德教授编的啊，他是在那个导引养生功他创编的一个系统，从那个系统里面抽了十二个动作整理改编而成的，是特意为了给那个健身气功啊，首先给大家介绍一下吧。健身气功跟导引养生功的分别，导引养生功呢是一个独立的系统，是在那个七十年代吧，由那个张广德老师因病后来呢要必须要离校休养，在那个休养的期间呢，他就通过家传的一些中医理论养生方法，再加上那个气功的理论吧，然后就整理创编的一套一个系统的功法吧。开始的时候呢只是为了让自己的病好起来，所以就练配合那个配合那个药物吧治疗，通过两三年的时间呢他就完全的康复了，所以呢他就在学校里面呢，在他工作的学校就是北京体育大学开始推广他这一套功法叫做导引养生功那个系统。在过去的四十多年吧，他已经创编了超过五十套的功法，学生呢也遍布全世界，在国内也是非常非常流行，在那个2000年，在中国气功管理中心跟其他的那个中医啊、体育学院跟教授跟一些叫做气功大师吧，一起来也是从那个在那个传统的气功的基础上整理编成一个叫做健身气功。这个健身气功呢它有益于其他的传统气功，因为健身气功呢是从那个传统的基础上加上了很多中医的理论，再加上现代的体育科学养生学营养学创编推广的。现在呢暂时的有九套功法在全面的推广，最近呢也出了两套新的功法，其中一套叫做明目功，有两个版本，一个成年版一个少年版青少年版，其他的气功呢就编为传统气功啊，所以呢就是这个呢就是跟有点不一样的跟那个导引养生功。但是导引养生功十二法呢是最近两三年前因为那个张广德老师已经九十多岁了，受到那个中国健身气功协会的邀请，从他这个系统里面吸取了十二个比较经典的动作 然后呢就编排这个套路成为现在我们叫做健身气功导引养生功十二法。所以大家呢说要清楚这一点，就是说它也是导引养生功，它也是健身气功，这是唯一的套路，是两边都可以用的。其他呢就是导引养生功或者健身气功是有点不一样的，所以呢大家要清楚这个区别吧。啊，所以导引养生功是一个系统，健身气功是另外一个系统。但是健身气功找导引养生功十二法是由庄港德老师创编，然后送给了中国健身气功协会作为中国健身气功系列的一个套路。这个套路的非常非常的好，我们再试一下看看，他现在好像有点回来了。回来了，稍等一下大家啊。
大家知道
任何事物的存在和发展都和缘有关系，都是在缘的形式状态下实现。
We know that all the movements in life on earth actually happen in circles. They accomplish, they grow, they evolve through circular movements.
从这个细胞啊，原子、电子啊，以及宇宙的运行，天道的运转，包括生物的繁衍生息。
So that applies to the evolvement and growth of cells, of atoms, of electrons, of the universe, and actually of every living being on Earth.
而且人体的气机活动也是在圆形的状态下循环下状态下循环的。
And also the human body moves in circles as well, especially when pushed by qi.
当然我们意识形态思想的进步，社会的发展也是螺旋式上升的。
Actually, our ideology, our way of thinking, and our social development actually all develop not in a straight line, but rather in a spiral, upward spiral.
因为这样呢，你可以兼修并蓄的容纳了很多的先进的东西。
That way, you can take in a lot of things that are considered to be positive, progressive.
如果是太直接、太直线、火箭式的上升呢，就会丢掉很多有用的东西。所谓走得太快，就会丢掉美景，就是这个道理。
So if you go in a straight line, especially shooting up like a rocket, actually you would be missing and losing a lot of things. And that is quite often what we mean when we say that when you're moving too fast, you are also losing a lot.
这个呢，其实是一个很简单的道理，就是说，当一个事物需要稳定性和灵活性兼具的时候，世界上往往稳定性和灵活性兼具的东西是无处不在的。这个时候呢，大家就采用螺旋式的形式来解决。
And the reason is quite simple, because when you need to have a combination of stability and flexibility, or pliability, in this case.Actually, there are many examples that we can find in life that require a combination of both, and then you would need a spiral movement to be able to achieve this.
我们中国人这个最有感受的就是用筷子夹菜。当碰上这个比较难夹的时候呢，我们不会两根筷子一起动，会一个固定一个动，然后稍稍有点摩擦旋转，它就起来了。
So a very good example is the way you use the chopsticks for the typical Chinese. Actually, when there is something that's difficult for you to get with your chopsticks, you don't move both chopsticks at the same time. You keep one chopstick stable and then move the other one, which rotates a little bit, actually, so that you increase the friction, and that helps with getting something up with your chopsticks very easily.
Ah, 那当然我们的经络我们的身体无处不在，原是无处不在的。
And in our meridians, for our body, you can also find a lot of circles. Actually, you can say circles are omnipresent.
那么这种四运原道的好处呢？主要是帮助改善关节的灵活性预防损伤等等。
And the benefits of having such circular movements is that it can help with increasing the flexibility of your joints and also prevent injuries.
当然呢，它也可以产生原动力，产生原动力，然后这个使我们这个身体内部运行正常。
It can also help generate the moving force so as to get the movements within our body back to normal.
当然最主要的我们应该通过这种圆的运动或者圆的姿势的这个调节来体会阴阳平衡，也就是说去学会判断阴阳，顺应阴阳，这个把握阴阳和这个调控阴阳的能力。
SoThe main point here is that through such circular movements or through such a regulation in circles, we can get the right feel of the balance between yin and yang, and we will be able to learn how to judge, how to regulate, and how to control the balance of yin and yang.
因为这种能力的提升你运用到学习工作生活当中，就可以不仅使自己受惠，而且还可以使你的朋友对手也一样获得很好的效益。
Actually, this kind of understanding, if applied to lifeAnd to your work, actually, will not only benefit yourself, but will also benefit your friends, your partners as well. And that will also help with our interpersonal relationship and also with the way we. Dealing with ourselves in terms of our psychology.
实际上马云先生呢，他做生意呢，就是遵循了这种阴阳和谐的理论，因为他从练太极当中体会和认识到这种理论，而且很好的运用到他的生意当中。
Actually, Jack Ma is a very successful example of this, because through his practice of Tai Chi, he was able to learn and understand this relationship between yin and yang, and was able to apply it to his business.
因为在他的这个从商过程当中呢，第一个呢，他是使大家都受惠，是使大家都受惠，这样的话呢，不要说话，使大家都受惠，这样的话呢，可以得到双赢，即使是无意中伤害了对方的利益，他也能够及时的调整过来，这样呢，大家共同进步，他的生意就越做越好。
And actually, in doing so, in his business, he's able to benefit everyone, not only himself. Just in case sometimes he discover in the competition he harmed the other side, he would just correct himself through this balance so that it could benefit everyone in the end.
所以我们在练习当中呢，一方面要自觉去体验。 另外一方面呢，要坚持用脑，用心去琢磨，这样呢，我们就能够进步。So
in our practice, we need not only to feel about it, try to get the feel of it, but also try to study, try to think about it as to how, and that will help with our further progress.
那么我们在练习的时候呢，适应原道，我们要注意，要杜绝这种直来直往的动作。So
in our practice, we need to get the moves circular. So we need to avoid at all costs getting the straight moves.
但这个说起来容易，做起来难。我看到很多人在做这个推掌的时候，都是一推过，直来直去一推过去，最后劲儿呢，全部都集中在肘关节上面。But
this is easier said than done. Quite often, when we see people when they're pushing their hands, actually they're pushing in a straight line and actually applying the force to the elbows. Instead.
这样呢，我们要推掌呢，我们给个口诀叫“欲推掌来，背先移”，就是背部先往后，帮助你的手臂往手掌往前推，然后要沉肩落肘，把腕顶，要顶腕，这样弧形前推。
So actually, when we push our hands, we have such an instruction. You need to actually move your back backward a little bit first, and also lower your shoulder, lower your pelvis and your elbows, while also lifting your bai hui.
这个呢，就是说，用背影呢，很符合牛顿第三定律，因为它会带来力量相等，方向相仿，在同一水平上。And
actually, you can apply Newton's third law here. Because when you are moving in a counter direction at the same level, and that will help with action and reaction.
还有一个就是我们当我们要摆臂向前，特别是摆臂向侧的时候，应该是先向下按掌，然后再往上摆，以手领先，叫烧结起。
And also, when you want to swing your arms sideways, you first of all, you start by pressing your hands down before you move up.
啊，那么再次强调，不要提肩肘。
Again, I need to remind you, that you don't lift your shoulders or elbows.
啊，那么我们啊，注意就是在这个练习当中呢，啊，就是要实现我们这个特点呢，我们要这个自觉的去体验这个太极理论，啊，要去学习太极理论，然后在练习过程当中呢，要做好充分的准备活动。
To give effect to this feature, we need to learn and experience the Tai Chi theories, and also to do proper warm-up before we start the exercise.
好，下面我们来到第三个特点，叫做逢动必旋，逢坐必扰。
Now let's come to the third feature. That is circular rotation with every move and twining with every pose.
啊，这个也很好理解，就是在动作当中呢，强调旋转、啊环转和缠绕。
And this should also be easy to understand. That means for every move, every pose, you emphasize the circular movement and also the twining move.Like a vine.
我们在导引养生功的练习里面呢，称它叫动在旋中起，坐在扰中停，啊，就无时无刻都有旋转的变化。
So, in our practice, we have this particular description, that is, moves start in rotation, while poses are formed.At the end of the twining move.
啊，大家看这几个动作，基本上都有旋臂。啊，摆臂的时候呢，手腕还在做环转，或者是说在这个内外的摆。啊，像第一个图，第一个动图，你看这个时候呢，手腕啊有点微微的啊，就手指微微的向外啊，叫外撇手，啊外撇手。啊，这个就不用多举例子，大家都清楚。那么我们来看看它的作用。啊，因为我们旋转呢，就是强调的手臂啊内外的旋转，这个呢可以加大它的扭矩，啊，就是加大它的扭矩，使它的这个对肌体的对肌肉啊骨骼的扭力加强，这样呢可以使我们的这个肌肉呢得到锻炼。啊，能够骨骼坚硬，啊，提升它的造血功能。
So you can see in the display here, actually, when you are swinging your arms, you are also moving your wrists, turning the wrists outward, especially led by the fingers here, and that has the effect of increasing the torque, so that you try to twist.Your muscles, your bones, and that in turn will help increase the hardness of the bones and also increase the function of blood building.
那么我们来看左上图啊，手三阴经呢是从胸走手啊，沿着手臂的前面往下走，然后手三阳经呢是从手走头，沿着手臂的背面呢往上走。
And let's look at the diagram on the left. This is the arms, San Ying meridians. Actually, they start from the hands to the elbows, while the three Yang meridians, they move from your hands all the way up to your head.
那当我们加强手臂的旋拧以后呢，它的力量会加强。这样的话呢，对这个手三阴三阳经的刺激呢就会增大，这样有助于启动内气， 畅通经络。
So when we increase the twisting, it will also help stimulate more the three yang meridians along the arms, and that will help trigger and generate the qi, and will also help unclog the meridians.
啊，那么根据中医理论啊，经络所过，主治所为。啊，脏腑所属，主治所及的原则，这个时候呢，对心经和肺经的刺激呢，啊，是可以达到保健啊，这个防治心肺疾病的目的的。
And according to the Chinese medical theories, where the meridians pass, they treat the operation.Where the zang and fu organs belong, they treat what they reach. And so that has the effect of treating illnesses relating to the heart and the lungs by impeding, or rather unclogging, the three yin and three yang meridians of the arms.
Ah.当你加强这个手腕的环转和踝关节的环转的时候，我们又可以有效的刺激这个十二正经的原穴。
By twisting our wrists and also ankles, actually, it will help stimulate the key acupoints, what we call the 12 acupoints.
啊，中医讲五脏有疾，当取十二元，这样呢，我们就可以调理十二脏啊，这个调理六啊，这个六脏六腑，使之啊得到保健，啊，使之功能增强。
So, by stimulating those acupoints, we in turn will help stimulate the zhang and fu organs.And that will in turn also help improve our overall health. So the screen is frozen, so I pray for your patience. They are trying to fix it. They can't see the screen. 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 They can't see
the screen. They can't see the screen. They can't see the screen. They can't see the screen. They can't see the screen. They can't see the screen. They can't see
the screen.
是什么原因？
或者胡老师，您可以继续说，那个他们在处理这个技术问题，反正能听到声音。
这个钉钉又停了啊，大家稍等啊，他们有事也是有问题了。暂时还没有回来，我估计他们还是在，修复，大家安心的等一等啊，一回来我就给大家 share 啊，好像有点回来了，可能看看是不是回来了啊，好，回来了，好，我现在就给大家那个啊，开始恢复。
得应该是主播室的问题。
不上了是吗？
你是不是不是主播室这个？
嗯，没事，一样可以。
连不上，那个翻译没了是吗？
你是不是邀请的上来？
都邀请了呀。
刚才我还听见你说话。
哎呀，又走了，不好意思大家啊，咱们那个中国健身气功协会啊，那个技术水平有待提高啊，不是他们的讲课水平，是他们的电脑啊，那个 computer science 那个技术水平有待提高，经常犯错啊，下一咱们要给他投诉一下啊，大家啊，我看看能不能给他找个什么来看看。啊，在等的时候给大家啊，稍等一下啊，给你看一看那个导演，
陈老师
连不上是吧？连不上。
陈老师，这当然正常。新来女
士。嗯，都正常，但是你要。
喂，没事吗？陈老师，陈老师说话，没有听不到的。
还听不到声音吗？
听不到，听不到声音。喂喂，陈老师。喂，
是不是他那个问题？
喂，陈老师。
连上了是吧？结束重新连一次吗？
这个是哪个地方？又少一个，按一个键。
不是。
刚才听见声音，后来没有。
他那边的那个。
喂，能听见吗？喂，胡老师，
哎，张老师好，听得见吗？
哎、张老师，对对对，可以可以。
哎，好好好，
太好了太好了。
嗯。
第二十八页，咱们第二
十八。嗯，躲开一点，站在往后，站在外面。喂。啊。不好意思，机器又出了一点问题，我们又休息了一下啊。好，下面继续啊。嗯。
So, as Professor Hu said, we had some technical problem again, and you had another break. Apologies again. Now let's resume.
啊，那么我们在练习的这个道理懂了，但是我们在练习的时候呢，我们要注意啊，就是旋臂的时候呢，我们要注意加强引力，充分的去旋臂。不是随便做一做就完了。
So now that we understand the theory behind it, we need to apply it to practice. That is, when we swing our arms, rather rotate our arms, we need to rotate fully, not just to do it as a casual move.
啊，当你要内旋的时候，你这个手臂张开来，啊，内旋是这个劲儿呢是不大的，应该用意念。然后呢，用拇指就是大鱼际往里靠，大鱼际往里靠，拇指往上挑， 帮忙它旋转，这样呢旋转就充分。
When you rotate inward, actually, the force would not be that big, would not be that great, and then you need to act to that with your mind, and also with your thumbs leading, and the muscle below your thumb is called 大鱼际, the thinner, and so you use the thumb to lead with the inward rotation.
啊，所以便于大家记忆呢，我们给一个口诀，叫“域内旋来，拇指领”，啊，就拇指往上挑领，逐渐加劲儿，心肺喜，啊，它畅通的是心肺经。
So to help you with that, we also have a rhyme, for instruction. That is, if you want to rotate inward, you, lead with your, 大鱼际, namely the, thinner muscle.And you apply your force, or rather increase your force, gradually, and that will help please your heart. That means it's good for your heart.
啊，同时呢，我们要注重于手腕的坐腕和提腕的动作。
We also need to pay attention to lifting, our wrists and also sitting on the wrists.
啊，同样的，我们的踝关节的绷绷和翘啊，就是脚掌的绷和翘，也要加强，因为我们的绷脚啊，因为我们的绷脚呢啊是可以起到刺激太白、健脾和胃；翘脚呢是翘脚连脚趾头都翘起来，可以起到刺激涌泉、调补肾气的作用。
So the same applies to the ankles, rather the feet. When we 是哪个我方向弄反了？就是说是说翘起来是、
啊、
是太白。
绷脚是健脾，翘脚、
哦、
连脚趾头都翘的是补肾。
Okay. So when you straighten your feet, that will help stimulate your 太白 acupoint.And will strengthen your, improve your spleen. And when you lift your toes, that means lifting the feet in another direction, lifting the toes, and that will help strengthen your kidneys. And also strengthen your, what's called the Yongquan acupoints under your feet.
啊，这个在十二法里面呢，表现的比较突出，大家要注意这一点。
And this kind of move is very particular. It's a very particular move, actually, for this Daoyin Yang Sheng Gong. And so we need to pay more attention to how to move them.
啊，建议呢，这个没播放了。啊，建议呢，就是我们在这个平时的行走当中呢，多练这个手臂的旋转和缠绕，这样以预防心脑血管疾病。
So one suggestion, in your everyday walking, you can try to flex your arms, your feet more by rotating them, what we call the twining.
第四个特点呢，就是行于之止，动其就是行于之止，气运稍解。
The fourth feature is called moving, or rather moves. We have the moves involving fingers. Here, there is a typo here. Fingers and toes, and qi reaching extremities.
那这个行于直止，气运稍解的实质呢，就是要加强肘膝以下部位的活动。然后把这个意念和精力引到我们的肢体的末端。
The actual translation of this, or interpretation of this particular feature is that in our exercise, we try to have our moves and our strength more focused on the parts of the body that's beyond our elbows. It means below our elbows and below our knees, so that we can exercise the extremities more, the ends of the limbs.
那这个在这个练习当中呢，很多典型的像这个足转啊、抖腕呐、叠腕呐、弹甲呀、这些动作呢，都是这个特征的表现。
And some of the typical moves for such an exercise would be the wrist movements, for example, raising the wrists, pressing the wrists.Flicking the wrist, rolling the fingers.
最典型的我们双阴悬阁侧摆臂的时候手指要先下探然后再内旋上摆。
A typical move would be a double fish hanging in the house, for example,You need to start by lifting your fingers, and then before you rotate inward.
因为这手指下探带动先肩下沉，百会上领，使你的这个气先昂实际上的得到的气血得到很好的这个调摄。
I correct myself. Actually, use if to move up.You need to reach down with your fingers first, while also lowering your elbows and your pelvis, while also lifting your bai hui, and that way it will help guide the qi upward.
我常常在教学当中呢形容这是长高高，就好像自己长高了一点似的，
So in my actual teaching.Quite often, I describe this move as growing up and up, you know, as if you were actually already growing. So when you rotate your body while...Also swinging your arms at all cost. Don't lower your lower back and also squat because that way will affect the actual the normal movement.
那我们强调刺激肘膝以下的部位呢，主要是刺激了十二正经的五腧穴。
So.The fact that we are emphasizing stimulating the extremities, that means the ends of our limbs, is intended to stimulate the 12 acupoints, or what we call the wushu acupoints.
那么五腧穴呢，就是指手指端的井穴，这个时候呢，是精气生发的地方。
So the five major acupoints are actually at the wrists. They're also called the walls acupoints, like the water well, so that they are where they can collect the water. In this case, the qi.
它是最容易被阻隔，因为有一颗小土疙瘩就会把它压住。
And these wells are the easiest to be blocked because with some clay there, and they can be just impeded.
然后再经过井穴，然后到行穴，就手掌、脚掌部位，然后到原穴、手腕、踝关节部位，逐渐的就变成小沟啊、小河呀、到大河。这个时候呢，气血就非常充盛。到了肘部呢，气血就非常充盛，就像汇聚成大河，川流不息，奔腾向前。
So actually, I correct myself. The 五腧穴 actually can be translated as the five kinds of acupoints. The first kind are the wells, where you have trickles, and then gradually the flood of qi will increase to more, and then to a current, to a river, and eventually to a huge a river. And so that way that the qi will increase step by step.
所以呢，我们一般针灸啊治病呢，都是取五主要取五腧穴来治疗。
So for acupuncture, actually, the doctor would normally focus on these five kinds of acupoints at the crucial passes.
第二个好处呢，就行医治治第二好处就疏肝利胆啊。我们知道肝主筋，气化在脏。
The second benefit of such a feature is that it helps us soothe the liver and improve the gallbladder. And we know that the liver governs the tendons, and the tendons' major manifestations are in what we call the claws, namely the toes and the fingers.
第三个作用呢，就是促进微循环啊，实际上这个跟前面的也有连带关系。
And the third function would be improving the microcirculation, which is also related to the previous functions.
微循环是万病，微循环障碍是万病之源。
Microcirculation disorders are the source of all diseases.
各位听众，不好意思，因为刚才我们机器出了点问题，所以呢耽误了一些时间，我们会延长一些时间，对不起。
Dear audience, just now we had some technical problems, and so that helped, actually took away some time. So to make up for that, we will extend the time for this lecture a little bit.
那个微循环障碍呢，和414种疾病和33种肿瘤有关系。
So micro mechanism disorders, or rather micro circulation disorders, are behind 414 kinds of illnesses and 33 kinds of tumors in the human body.
所以我在这个。德国的疗养院看到啊，他们的疗养中心呢，有很多老年人就去玩那种啊，这个用温水泡手臂啊，然后呢直步啊，这个下棋下那有磁铁的棋。
Once I visited a rehabilitation center, or recuperation center, in Germany.And I found that the elderly people, the patients there, they dip their limbs in warm water and they learned how to weave cloth, and also they were playing with chess, but a kind of chess with the pieces that were magnetic.
这里最值得一提的是这个刺激我们的末梢啊，就是运动梢节最主要的作用呢，可以抑制啊，使我们的大脑皮层得到的锻炼这个增加，预防阿尔茨海默病。
What needs warrants particular mention is the fact that by exercising the extreme ends of our limbs, it will also help train.Or exercise our brain, and that would be very good for stalling Alzheimer's disease.
我们在这张图上可以看到啊，一个拇指的这个活动是对大脑皮层的刺激，是我们大腿的十倍。
We had one particular study.是活动什么是活动大腿的十倍啊？就刺激大腿
活动一个拇指 对大脑皮层的刺激相当于活大腿活动的十倍。
So, we had one study that found that by just exercising your, thumbs, actually, the stimulation your brain gets from this exercise is 10 times the exercise of your thighs. But such rotation exercises and also exercises involving the fingers and toes need to be guided by your mind so that the qi will go wherever your mind goes.
不能把自己的肢体当作钢体无限度的把它这个力量加强或者是无限度的放长放远应该用意识引导。
So we can't treat our limbs
人是肉体
as steel because after all, the limbs are also made of flesh and bones, so we can infinitely increase the force apply, and we cannot infinitely extend our limbs.
另外一个呢就是动作要做的精细准确我看到很多人在练芙蓉出水的时候叠腕卷指弹桨就根本就没弹到浮皮潦草或者是弹的这个强度不够这个呢都应该避免或者预防
And also in your moves you need to be very accurate, very precise, refined for example, Professor Hu noticed that many of us when we practice the lotus flower emerging from the water and there is a series of moves including the flicking of the fingers and quite often we just do it, you know, quite casually without being very particular and without getting the right duration for the moves required.
当然我们在练习除了练习之外我们闲暇时间可以做一些这个手工啊
So in addition to exercise, we can also, in our own leisure time, move with our hands, as you can see in the video.
看我这个右边这个动画不是变魔术哈，就是练出来的反应。
You just try to exercise and see how quickly you can move. It's not magic.
另外呢也可以用球来练实际上我建议以后练那个导演生功十二法都可以持这个球来捏球练习可以这个改善微循环预防阿尔茨海默症
Actually we can also play with balls in our hands Actually Professor Hu is suggesting that in your future exercise you can hold two balls while doing the 导演养生功And that will help actually to prevent Alzheimer's disease.
确实应该注意预防，因为我们今天有报道说我们中国已经有三亿人口是老年人，包括我
Indeed, we need to pay particular attention to prevention because there was one report today saying that in China.There are already 300 million people who are the elderly, including, the, as Professor Hu said, including himself.
已经进入到中度老年社会状态，而这种情况下，这个阿尔茨海默病的人数必将会大幅增加。
So such a group has already entered the what's called the middle of the elderly age range. And so for this age group, it's more likely for them to get this Alzheimer's disease.
啊，那么第五个特点呢，就是在练习当中强调蹲起和腰背的旋拧俯仰。
So the fifth feature is the emphasis on squatting and rise, and also a greater emphasis on weights, on the waist and back.
啊，那么这个例子很多啊，比比皆是，就不多举了啊。
There are many examples, and so
看这个躬身
elaborate
啊，像这个侧弓步。
For example, you can see there's a, it's called the side with both step, both stands, and also bending.
嗯，还有马步、歇步、
rest step.
啊，还有独立步啊，腰背的旋转，它有什么好处呢？主要是。
So it shows the benefit of your waist rotation.
啊，主要是补肾。
So it, essentially, this is for strengthening your kidneys.
啊，因为啊，这个腰为肾府，啊，督脉贯脊属肾。
Because
命门其气与肾通。
Because the lower back is supposed to be the house of the kidneys, and the du meridian runs through the, or rather runs along the spine. It also belongs to kidneys.
而肾气呢，又是主宰人们的生长壮老矣的，也就是说，可以帮助我们延年益寿。
And the qi from kidneys.Is actually the command or the commander of our growth, including our birth, growth, our adulthood, our aging, all the way. So by replenishing or tonifying our kidneys, it can help extend our years of life.
而我们的马步，我们的这个步伐移动是在虚实分明的情况下。柔和缓慢的用力。
So when you form the horse stance, actually, you apply the force very slowly, and also in between, alternating between the, what we call solidity and emptiness.
啊，那么我们啊有研究表明，这种情况下，对于这个练习者的这个睾酮的分泌有很好的帮助。啊，同时呢，可以使我们的骨密啊骨密度增加，预防骨质疏松。
Studies have found that such an exercise will help increase the decretion of our testosterone, and also increase the density or maintain the density of our bones.
啊，当然呢，它更。更好的作用是有助于我们。
A greater benefit is to help with our steadiness in our walking, so as to prevent tripping ourselves.
这样的话，我们的生命质量就能够得到提升。
And that way, it will improve the quality of our life.
大家看看我们这个左上啊右上图的这位老人，啊
，So you can look at the. You can look at the picture on the top right. This elderly gentleman, he's already 84 years of age.
啊，他就是啊钟南山贤医生啊。
That's a doctor.钟南山
啊，刚刚获得了国家医学国家的英雄称号。
He was recently awarded the title of national hero in China. I think only five got this award this year. And the first time, I think it was given out 2 years ago, President Putin was one of them. Only two for the first year.
我们练健身气功练这个导演养生功十二法，我们的下肢力量和腰部力量呢是得到了锻炼，但是呢我们还应该注意在练功之余呢要加强一些上肢的力量练习。
So by doing practice in Health Qigong in general and 导演养生功 in particular, we are able to exercise our lower limbs and our lower waist as well.But in our everyday life, we also need to pay attention to exercising the upper part of our body as well.
Ah, 那么我们的步态稳定呢？这个性激素分泌增加了啊，这个我们的生活的幸福指数会提高。
So by keeping ourselves steady, increasing our stability, and also increasing our sexual hormones, that will also increase our own sense of happiness.
那么我们加强腰背的旋拧，像这个弓身胆穴这个动作，使脊柱一节节的旋拧，然后加强我们的这个马步。和侧弓步，这些呢都是对我们的核心区啊进行整体的调摄，啊进行对核心区进行很好的调理。
So by the bending ourselves as if in the movement entitled the bending down to the brush of your shoes, we are actually flexing.Our spine sectionally, and also through other moves such as the horse stance and also the side bow stance, we actually try to rotate the spine sectionally, and that helps stimulate and strengthen what we call the core zone. And it will help with preventing the
整脊塑形。
And that will help with what we call the overall shaping of our body.
整脊塑形不光是外形好，而且可以对内脏进行很好的保护，而且有利于气血循环。
So it's not just something outward, just the outward exterior, but will also help.Protect our internal organs and also help with the movement of qi and blood.
而且呢，这种核心区的这个核心区的健康呢，它的这个力量的发出呢，可以对整个四肢的力量的输出呢，这个进行的很有效，可以防止运动损伤，所以奥林匹克选手都在这个注重核心区的锻炼。
So through the exertion of force in this what we call the core area, it will help with the output through our four limbs as well. That's why the Olympic athletes they also pay great attention to there's a core area because that will also help with preventing injuries.
那么我们的练习要点呢主要是就做马步大家都是很头疼的事又是哈腰又是撅臀又是跪膝又是膝脚不对。
When it comes to practicing with the horse stance, Professor Hu finds quite worrisome, distressing even, is that there are so many erroneous wrong moves. For example, you bend your knee, you have the knees, what we call the kneeling knee, that means the knees protruding before the toes, and also the, have your butt out, or have your knees not well aligned with the toes, all the problems. To keep yourself in an upright position, to get it all right, the key here is to lower your pelvis, while also lifting your top. So don't you ever think that when we squat, we have to bend our knees. Actually, we lower our pelvis and that will help bend our knees.
然后我们的脚尖和膝关节老是对不准呢，我们要注意在开步移重心的时候，两脚跟呢要稍稍的外撑，啊，就是外摆一点，边移重心边外摆脚跟，使脚尖向前，啊，这个但是形成向内合的趋势。So
when you are squatting, quite often the toes are not well aligned with the knees. How to correct that? You actually move out your heels a little bit, and that will help the toes coming in a little bit, and that way will help with the alignment.
第二个呢，就是要强调虚，动作柔缓，虚实分明。
Secondly, we need to stress the need for a distinction between solidity and emptiness in our moves, and that will help increase the intensity of our strength. And third, when we turn our waist, we need to combine both the twisting with the pulling. And here, one example is Ji Chang shooting at the louse.
公孙胆宣呢，要强调对脊柱的结节牵拉，就是旋拧，叫做一摩三经。And
for the movement entitled bending down to brush off the shoes, you here you need to have the rotation, the pulling in opposite directions, and here you are supposed to massage the three young leg meridians.
这就是说，最好是要按摩到脚背部的、腿背部的膀胱经，然后侧面的这个胃经和胆经。
It would be best for you to be able to massage the bladder meridian in the back of the legs, and also the stomach and gallbladder meridians on the sides.
这实际上呢，对腰部肌肉的这个牵拉也起到了这个弹筋分筋的作用，就按摩中分筋的作用，那么腰背的气血循环呢就可以改善。
That actually will also help massage the meridian, or rather the muscles in your lower back. and that will help us unclog the meridians as well.
那我们这里要强调的是，第一，基本功要注意锻炼；第二呢，就是在做大幅度的旋转、俯仰的时候呢，还有这个马步的时候呢，这个有这个有高血压的、有椎间盘突出的要慎重。
And here we need to emphasize that we need to bolster our basic skills training, and when you do certain moves such as rotation or horse dance for people who have hypertension or who have it's called the spinal disc herniation, and try not to do those moves, or at least be prudent when you do it.
第六个呢，就抻筋拔骨，强调反序。
The sixth feature is stretching tendons and bones while focusing on counter moves.
他的意思呢，就是说要对拔拉长就肢体的对拔拉长而且呢，要强调做和平时习惯相反的姿势和动作。
So the emphasis here is pulling the limbs in opposite directions and also trying to do moves that are the opposite of what you are normally doing in life, opposite in terms of directions.
这个呢，在练习当中呢，也这个非常多的体现。
And this is found in a lot of manifestations. For example, the golden rooster heralding dawn.
For example, 那这个练习呢，它有什么好处呢？首先是易筋联络，就是把你的关节把关节这个拉开然后使它的这个韧带神经血管软骨盘还有肌腱都得到撑拉。
And the first benefit of such a move is to stretch out and loosen your joints.You try to pull your ligaments, tendons, your nerves, and also the other muscles and other organisms.
不，这个不仅有利于我们身体的肢体的这个活动，而且有助于我们精神的安宁。
So this is good not only for our physical exercise, but also is good for the serenity of our mind.
第二个好处呢，就是疏肝利胆。因为我们抻筋拔骨呢和反序呢，都会使我们的身体对拔拉长，因为肝属木，喜疏泄调达。
And the second benefit is soothing the liver, and facilitating bile flow, because the liver belongs to wood, and it likes a dispersion and unimpeded openness.
同时抻筋拔骨大部分呢都要刺激到你的腋下胁肋部。
Also stretching and pulling the ligaments and the bones will also help stimulate your armpits.
而《黄帝内经》讲肝有邪，其气流于两腋。
Because according to the Yellow Emperor's inner classic, whenever you have the evils, in this case, it means the illnesses, they start from underneath your armpits.
当然它有补肾的作用， 啊，这个上面前面已经说过，这里不再赘述。
It also has the effect of tonifying your kidneys, of course, as we mentioned earlier.
啊，那么第三个呢？啊，它可以畅通督脉，啊，调理三焦，啊。
The third benefit is unblocking the Ren and Du meridians and regulating Sanjiao the triple burners.
第四个呢，就是改善平衡，弥补薄弱环节，因为它是做反训嘛，啊，锻炼的是平时锻炼不到的地方。
The fourth benefit is improving balance and replenishing the weaker parts of the body because since you are doing the moves in an opposite direction, like arcing your body rather than bending, and you exercise the parts of the body that you would not normally exercise.
同样的呢，它可以因为撑筋拔骨，使你的这个韧带啊，身体柔韧。又灵活又稳固，啊，这样的可以益寿延年。
Also, by stretching the ligaments and the bones, you can make yourself more pliable, and that will also add on to your years of life.
反训还有一个很好的作用，就是可以放松我们的精神。
Having the opposite direction exercises has another benefit, that is, it helps invigorate our mind, lift our spirit.
当我们用这个左手的时候，这个左手支配左手运动的神经呢，它兴奋。当我们用右手的时候，右手就兴奋。那么我们老是用左手呢，那它这个。这个神经系统就会紧张，然后你不用左手的时候，你要，间断的用右手呢，它就会使你得到放松休息。
For example, when we use our left hand, it will stimulate those parts of the nervous system that control it, and vice versa, when we use the right hand, it will stimulate the parts that control it.But if we keep using the left hand, for example, it will just keep those parts in a nervous state. And if we change to another hand, and it will allow parts of the nervous system to have a break.
当然，这个它还有助于预防一些办公室症状以及疾病。
Of course, it will also help with treating or removing some of the syndromes that we have, as we call them, the office syndromes, such as the frozen shoulders or the neck shoulder syndrome, lower back pain, etc.
就很多朋友告诉我，胡老师啊，我练着理三焦，我这个肩周炎就好很多啊。
And some of the practitioners told me that, oh, when I try to practice this regulating the 三焦 the triple burners, actually, my symptoms have improved a lot.
当然我们练习的时候要注意动作疏松对拔拉长以及在旋拧的状态下拉长。
In our practice, we need to pay attention to the following. First of all, we need to space out the moves and pull and stretch in opposite directions and doing all this while in rotation.
当然我们要强调用力不用力以及动静相间等等。
We also need to focus on the mind rather than focusing on using force. And we also need to alternate between the dynamic and static states.
最重要的呢，我们在适度在这个 在外静内动的情况下，适度的采用旋吸，也就是说，我们吸气啊，用力啊，就是对拔拉长，然后呢，这个稍停，然后再呼出去。这样的话呢，可以不仅调节植物神经，而且可以使我们的这个韧带啊，就是筋啊，韧带之间的这个啊刺激得到加强，以及对我们的经络穴位也加强，也刺激增大。
More importantly, when we do it, we need to hold our breath as appropriate. That is, you need to hold your breath before you spread out the limbs and do the stretching. And that will help stimulate also your nervous system, your tendons, and also the related acupoints.
那么应该注意的就是要做好充分的工前准备。
What we need to pay particular attention to also is to have a proper, appropriate warm-up before the practice.
最后一个特点呢，就是采脸结合，吞金咽玉。
The last feature is combining collection and storage and swallowing the saliva.
所谓采呢，就是我们的这个采气。脸就是脸气。
So,
那么挡养神功有个手型。
By this collection, it means collecting qi, and storage means storing qi. And actually, in Daoyin Yang Sheng Gong, you use a particular gesture for the arms, for the hands.
它的手型呢，就是食指上挑，大鱼际往里收。使手掌心呈凹状，便于采气。
Actually, you form the hand by lifting your index finger out, and by taking in, moving in your the muscle below the thumb, which is called the fina, and also by keeping a hollow in the palm, so that you can collect qi in that way.
那么如果是手指一炸，手掌一摊，这样的效果就差一点。
Instead, if you don't lift your index finger and you keep your arm and your palm flat, the effect for qi collection would be weakened.
吞就是吞咽唾液。
So this swallowing is easy to understand. It's simply swallowing the saliva.
这个在宫尾大家都做过这个脸气和吞金咽液
You have all done this movement. That is towards the end of the practice. You collect qi and you also swallow the saliva.
那么这里的要强调的就是，我们有向外向里的动作，有向上向下的动作。要强调向下向里。
Here you have the moves that move out or inward, and you also move up and down. Here we need to emphasize the particular directions of moving in and moving down.
然后吞金咽液呢，要强调一手金金玉液。舌下腺津津玉液产生唾液。
It needs to be emphasized that when you do the swallowing, just watch the video. Actually, you need to focus your mind on swallowing the saliva, and that way it helps generate more saliva in the mouth.
采气点去蓄气的就是。主要作用就是壮中补元。
So the purpose of this collection and storing of qi is to increase the vital essence and to tonify yourself, to strengthen yourself.
所谓养的丹田软融融，此事神仙真要诀。
as we say, keeping the dantian warm is the key to health. Actually, it's more than the key to health. The real translation would, correct translation would be, this is the key to, or rather the secret to immortaldom. That means to become someone with longevity.
你看我们这个道家这个创造的药字就是看这个左右下图是自家水。
Let's look at the Chinese character in the lower right corner. And that's not a character you can find in a dictionary. It's the character for the word medicine or drug. Actually, it comprises of three Chinese characters. On the top left is self, and then on the top right is home, and the lower part would be water. All three to make up this word called medicine.
我们古人造字的是舌旁有水才能活。
Also, the ancient Chinese, when they created the Chinese character words or word characters, actually, for example, the word alive, they combined the tongue with water to make up this word called alive.
实际上现代研究也发现它有溶菌酶，有消化酶。
In fact, according to the contemporary studies, in the saliva, you can find a lot of things, including a lot of enzymes and also some proteins.
So we have to preserve it, protect it, called "金金玉叶."
That's why we need to treasure it and conserve it. And that's why the saliva in Chinese can be described as the golden essence, or rather golden fluid and jade nectar.
那提醒大家的是，就是又容易做到，又时时忘记的，就是吃饭的时候的细嚼慢咽，就能产生唾液。
What I need to remind you is something that's easy to do but easily forgotten as well. That is, when you are eating, try to be slow and try to chew more, and that will help generate a lot of saliva.
那么我们用了两个来小时的时间，把导养生功十二法的动作特点给大家简单的介绍了一下。So
I have spent a little bit more than over 2 hours to give you a brief description about the major features of this 12-step 导引养生功。
要注意，这个我们只是讲了动作特点，其实我们的练功，动作是基础，呼吸是动力，调神是核心，我们绝不能偏废。But
it must be emphasized that today we have just touched on the features of this routine. Remember that our moves form the basis. Our breathing provides the driving force, and our mind is the core. And don't just neglect this essential.
我们的讲座呢就到这里。首先感谢各位的参与。
So we are coming to an end for this presentation. First of all, may I thank you all for your participation, your listening. I also thank all the interpreters who are teachers themselves for their outstanding performance.
再次感谢中国健身气功协会和国际健身气功联合会。
Once again, my thanks to the China Health Qigong Association and the International Health Qigong Federation.
当然还要感谢我的助手庄永昌老师、庞祥吉老师，还有徐文新、胡婷。
Also, of course, I need to thank my assistants, Professor Zhuang Yongchang, Mr. Pang, and some other assistants as well.
因为时间关系和我个人的水平问题，肯定讲座中有很多存在的问题，希望大家批评指正。
So due to the time constraint and also because of my limited understanding, and there must be a lot of problems, and I welcome your corrections.
那么其他问题呢，可以联系咱们讲座的主办方。
If you have questions, you may
汇总以后一起解答。
The organizers of this event, when the questions have been collected, I can answer them at one go.
也希望大家持续关注中国健身气功协会和国际健身气功联合会的通知和动态。谢谢大家。
And I also invite you all.To continue to follow the notices and other events presented by the China Health Qigong Association and the International Health Qigong Federation. Thank you very much.
再见。
Good night.